Assalamualaikum. By the blessing of Almighty Allah, hope so you are fine. Yes, Alhamdulillah, I am also fine. From Milestone Preparatory KG School, Class 4, Sector 7, Uttara, Shahina Hussain, in front of you with Mathematics Online Class. Students, I am ready for the class. Are you ready with your necessary things? Okay, let's come to the class. Today, I will share with you creative math. How can we solve the creative math problem? Today, we will see these things, okay? Now, let's come to the class, please. Come on the board. Take your math CW copy with your necessary things, okay? Now, let's come. Before starting class, see the things. See the creative math. Today, at first, I will do creative math 1. First, read the question. Read the whole math, okay? 0.43 and 0.06. That means 0.43 and 0.06 are two decimals. That means two are the decimal fractions. Write the given numbers in word. First requirement. They are giving two instruction to information us. So what is their requirement? First one, write the given numbers in word. That's mean we are finding the words. We will write the number in words both of these decimals. And number B, determine the place value of 0.43. That's mean first fraction. Number C, compare the values of the above pair of decimals by using greater, smaller, equal in between them. That means we are comparing. We will compare the decimals. Number D, express the second number into fraction and find the lowest value. So, let's come on the board. First option, that means number 1. Solution. Number A. How can we write the numbers in word? Okay. First decimal 0.43. So how can we find the answer? Here 0. We write the 0. Then this is the 0.43, 4, then 3. We already learned in this chapter when we are writing any decimal fraction or decimal, that's time after decimal we are not uttered the digits as like 43. We are mentioning the number, we are mentioning the digits individually as like 0, decimal or point, this point and 4, 3. Okay, separately we are write the number. Now second one, 0.06. How can we write that one? Okay, 0.06. Okay, this is the answer. By this way, we are writing this decimal in words. Now, number B. Number B is there. Determine the place value of 0.43. That means we are finding the place value of given fraction. At first, we write the fraction. 0.43. Now we are finding the place. Before writing the answer, I just review the information. You know the decimal, that means point position is 1. In the decimal map, point's position is 1. From the right side, if point position is 1, so what is the position, what is the place of 4? Obviously 10. And what is the place of three. You are right. Three place is 100. So how can we write there? 300 hundredths. That's mean 0.03. And 4 tenths. 4 tenths. That's mean 0.4. And what is the zero's position? Zero's place is only zero, because when we are writing before decimal any digit, zero is before the left side of the decimal of decimal's position. Zero is the one's place, but zero has actually no place. We cannot keep any place for the zero. So how can we write zero? Zero's place is zero unit. So we write here only zero. Okay, we are just write there zero, nothing. So by this way we are writing the place value of decimals. Now let's come number C. Compare the values of the above pair of decimals by using greater, smaller, equal in between them. So how can we find the, how can we compare it? How can we find out which decimal fraction is smaller or which one is bigger? So now we are showing the things. Here .43 and 0.06. So therefore we can find 0.43 equal to, for the decimal one, and the how many digits are there? 2 digits. So we are writing there double, 20. For 4, 10, for 3, another 0. Now upper side we are writing there 43. Now let's come 0.06. How can we write the things? For the decimal one, how many digits are there? 2 digits. So we are writing there 20. Upper side before 6 there is the 20, so you cannot write 0, you are writing there only 6. So easily you can find out. Both denominators are equal, 100 and 100. So now we are following the numerators, which one is bigger? 43. 6 is smaller. So we can write the things, 43 by 100 is bigger than 6 by 100. Okay, so by this way we can write the answer. Answer is 0.43 is bigger than 0.06. okay, up to that I think no problem. Now let's come number D. At first I rub the board. Now let's come to number D. Express the second number into fraction and find the lowest value. Second number is what? Second decimal is 0.06. So we can write as like here 0.06. Now 0.06 equal to, we already find the answer previous number. Now we are find the lowest from 3 to the 6, 50 to the 100. So we can cut the matching number, that's mean 2 and 2. So my answer is now he get the answer 3 by 50. Okay, answer is, it's come 3 by math. Creative math 2. At first, we'll read the math. Okay, let's come. Here, Urmi has taka 250 and her mother has given her taka 125.50. She goes to bookshop to buy a book taka 185.25 and a notepad taka 4.75. This is the statement. Now, what is their requirement? At first, number A, write in words the amount of money that Urmi's mother given to her. Number B, how much money does she has in total? Number C, how much money does she expend in total? Number D, how much money does remain with her? That means there are four options, four requirements. So let's come, we will solve the problem now. Creative math 2 solution. Number A. Number A. Urmi's mother gives her taka 125.50. So how can we write the answer? Now that means we are finding the words in number. Okay, number in words. 125.50. That's me. 125.50. Answer is 125.50. After decimal, we cannot say 50. We are utter the digit. We are tell the digit or number 5 and 0. Okay. This is the answer. Now let's come number B. How much money does she has in total? That means we add number B. She has how much money? Urmi has taka 250. It is not mandatory. We are writing the decimal after 00. It's not mandatory. If we will write, it's better. Her mother gives her taka 125.50. That means we will add the answer. Okay. Now, total she has. How much? Now we will add 0, 0 plus 0, then 0 plus 5. Decimal point must be same. When you are writing the decimal point, it's a parallel position. Now 0 plus 5, so 5 come automatically. 5 plus 2, it will be 7. 3 plus 1, 2 plus 1, it will be 3. So my answer is, I get the answer, taka 375 point 5 0. That's mean Urmi has total 375.50 taka. Okay. Now let's come number C. First I rub the board. Number C. Now, how much money does she spend in total? That's mean she buys what? How can she spend her money? At first, she buys a book. Taka 185.25. And a notepad taka only 4.75. That's mean total she expends taka. So how 5 5 plus 10 0 1 is in our hand. Again 10 decimal is here, so again 1 6 plus 4, again 10 0, another, so 9 then 1. So answer is total she expends taka 190. Okay, round amount she has spent. So number D. Now number D. What is the requirement? How much money does remain with her? That means already we got answer. At first, she has total 375.50 taka and she expends this amount. So we are just subtracting the digits, or we are find the difference. Okay. Now she has total taka 300. How much? We are getting the answer. How much? 375.50. She expends total taka 190. I can give there 0 double 0. If you want to write anything, you can write here from B, then from C. Okay, we are finding the answer. Upper one answer from B, upper one the second one, that's the lowest one, lower one we are getting from C. Okay, now we are finding the answer. Remain with her. How much money? Now, from 0 to 0, then 5. It's come automatically. From 5 again. Now, here 7. 7 is smaller than 9, so I need to borrow 1. It will make 17. 17 minus 9, it is 8. Here is 2. Okay, now 1. That's mean my answer is Urmi has taka 185 decimal, that's mean 0.50. Remain now she has done it to collect your homework. Homework number 7. Homework now 7. Do creative math 3. Where you will get the creative math 3? Yes, you are right. You will collect the creative math from here. Okay. At first I read the math. Creative math 3. Sam's travel 5.52 km, 10 mil km, by bus 12.65 km by train and 2.36 km by rickshaw. Now, what is there? What are their requirements? Number A, how many kilometers did he travel in total by bus and train? Number B, how many kilometers did he travel in total by train and rickshaw? Number C, how many kilometers did he travel in total? That's when you will find the total. Number D, how many kilometers did he travel by train more than by bus? That's mean you will find the difference. Okay, by this way, at first you collect the creative map. Number three, for your homework, submit your homework to your respective section group. Okay, teachers will collect your homework from your group. And now my class is over, but keep your practicing at home because this is final done. Allah Hafiz.